I'm glad you could both make it. One of my privileges when I get to call the finalist filmmakers and tell them they made it, it was the week of your birthday.
Yeah.
And you invited me to your birthday party. So I couldn't make it to New York, but I'm glad we can be here and celebrate now. So thank you so much. Well, congratulations on the film. We absolutely loved it. All the tender moments and the relationship building and the intimacy. You have an amazing backers as well for the project. The Darden brothers, Martin Scorsese, executive produced it. How did this film come to be?
Big question. Actually, I started to write the movie when she was really small, and I had the idea to make the movie with her, like, but a very small team and everything. And it started to be like the Darden were interested in the script I wrote, and then we were like, okay, maybe we should do like a big movie, so we waited a little bit more. And I spent a lot of time watching her everyday life, and as a young mother, I needed to spend a lot of time raising her, so I was like, maybe I should mix my job and raising my kids. That makes a movie. It could be interesting, so exactly what I did. And I'm very glad that, because now she, for her, like, it's a big thing. And it's very nice, like, to see how the public is enthusiastic. Yeah. But
how many times has she seen the movie? How many times have you seen the movie?
She's trying, she's learning English.
Thank you. Do we have any questions right off the bat from the audience? Yes, we're in the middle.
How long did it take to make the film?
We had like 5 weeks. Well, the shooting was 5 weeks. It was really quick. But we did like a lot of, not rehearsal, because the idea of the project is what, like, she didn't know anything about the story. So she thought like Antoine was really like Antoine, like a friend of her mother in the movie. So we shot like chronologically every scene. So she saw, the first time she saw Antoine was like the first day of the shooting. They never have met each other. So, and we really like, yeah, tell her the story day by day. And for her to remember the scene, she drew like the script with picture, because she could not read at the time. So she drew every scene herself, and she was like, oh, mommy, maybe she can do that, and she can do this. So she also bring a lot of ideas in the movie. And the last scene you saw, like, about the secret, it was really, like, for her the first time that I told her, like, actually, this guy was playing her father in the movie. And so it's really real for her, like, and I wanted to do that because I didn't wanted her to be, like, a parrot or something. I really wanted her to be the way she is, and that is, I think you can feel it. Like, she's really herself. And so yes, it was a long preparation, but a very short time of shooting. Wow. Yeah.
Okay. Yes, okay. Another question over here. Right here. Yes.
So how did you handle the script then? Was it all ad lib?
Yeah.
So how did you handle the script? Was it all ad lib?
Yeah. So the complicated stuff with the production staff was to make them understand that maybe Lina and Antoine won't get along together. So it was an option that the movie will be totally different. Like, they will hate each other, for example, or she will not accept him. And then the story will be how a father cannot connect again to his daughter. So it was a possibility. So every day we were like, and by chance, I mean, they really get along together. So it was easier for me. I didn't write the script day by day. But yes, there were this option, like, the movie can be totally different and I will have changed everything, because I always want in my work, my work is based on the family set. Like, I really like to see how the bonds are creating inside the people of the family. So I wanted it to be, I always use like the real life, the way the people get along together, and the fiction, I mix both to get like this reality thing that I think you can feel in the movie. Yeah.
Thank you. So we have another question over here? Yeah.
Was it hard to direct as her mother?
Yeah, very hard. No, it was really, really hard, because she, at the beginning, she's not an actress, obviously, she was 5 at the time, so she didn't really understand what was my job and what she doing here in the set. So we had like a lot of, I had a coach for her, and she had a lot of ritual, like like we had a special ring to tell her like it's now the first shooting or now we rehearse and everything, and she starts slowly to understand, like after a week I think she got it, like the emotion and everything, but it was a really long preparation, and at the beginning she was all the time looking back at me like, mommy, what should I do? so we had a special magical baguette, like I don't know, so like and so the coach will say like, okay, now your mother is the director and now you're not Lena, you're Elsa. So we, and it worked a lot actually, this method. And then this is the way we manage.
Yes. Does she want to do more?
It's a question to Blanco for the film?
Yes.
Well, she's a friend because she can't speak English, so she said my father.
And where is he?
She doesn't know.
What was the most fun for you, Elsa?
What was the most fun for... What was the most fun for Lena?
When she said, like, it was really fun when, like, you know, the brother is telling me, like, won't you say something to her? And then he says she doesn't give a damn. And then she says, like, I don't give a damn.
Is there any question up there? No?
No.
Okay. So I guess you knew
initially, so that Lena was going to be in the film too. But talk about the casting of Antoine.
Yeah.
Did you have to do some? Did you say they never met beforehand?
No.
But did you know Antoine that was the right actor right away?
Yeah. So I did a lot of casting because I was not sure about who can play the father, and I wanted like a guy that looks like a kind of Peter Pan, like not really a father actually, like someone that could have run away for 5 years. So I saw a movie, a Belgian movie, where Thomas, actually is his name, was playing in, and I thought like this guy is really the good type. Like, I mean, he really looks like an old kid. He doesn't really look like someone that takes responsibility. So I think it was interesting to confront both of them.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why I chose him.
Perfect.
Tell us about what's next for the film. About there's some release plans and people can continue to see it.
Yeah. So I think the movie is already on Amazon or something, like on the platform. It sells everywhere, but I mean on VOD most of the time.
Mm-hmm.
I think. So yes, and now she's willing to play. Like she told me the other day, she told me, "You like playing your next film?" And I was like, "I don't know." I mean, it was so hard, but I don't know. We for the next, I don't know. It's gonna be, maybe there will be 10 years later, like the relationship with you. It's interesting to me to maybe to do.
Tell us about your film career. How did you get into movie making as well? And what did you start with, short films? Have you only done features?
Yeah, I have a special background because I never did a short movie.
Mm.
I start with a long feature film. I never finished school. I think as a kid as well, I had the dream of being, like, it's very banal actually, but I had the dream of being like a filmmaker, and I was working in the TV in Belgium, and one day I was like, okay, I need to do something, otherwise I will stay at the TV and I will never try to make films. So I get out of the TV and I try to write my first movie, where she is in, also she was a baby at the time. So I did this film, and then, yes, this long feature film, and then I continued to write, and I really, I mean, I did everything like in a kind of autodidact way. Like, I never really, I had difficulties with the short format, because to me it's very difficult when you want to observe how a link can grow between two people in 15 minutes or 20 minutes. For me, it's like, I don't manage with this format, so I always like wrote long feature, like very small, like just people together and how they get along with each other and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
Any other questions? Yes,
I would just like to say we fell in love, and tugged at our heartstrings, and it brought tears in a very memorable film. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. Do you want to be a filmmaker? Do you know what you want to be when you grow up?
She doesn't.
You don't know? That's okay.
She said that she still wants to play. Like she said,
I think I can again play in a movie maybe, but
You can just be a kid for a while. That's
yeah,
okay.
Yeah, I think it's good.
We'll focus on that. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, perfect.
Okay.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Thanks so much, everyone. It was
yeah.
Thank you.